Hi there, Nate from Travel Lemming here. I'm an American who's been traveling the world since 2016, and I produce lots of guides and travel tips, so you can go ahead and hit that subscribe button to follow along. But today we're gonna be talking about my recommended itinerary for my favorite country on the planet, and that's Georgia. So in today's video, I'm gonna go ahead and briefly talk about how long it is that you need to visit Georgia, and then I'm gonna walk through my recommended 14-day itinerary for taking in the best of this awesome and incredible country. Okay, so how long do you need to visit Georgia? Here's the thing, Georgia's a small country. So if you look out on a map, you might say, well, you know, 5 to 7 days is probably enough. I can do this in a week. And while I think if all week's all you have, you should still definitely come to Georgia and you can see quite a lot just on day trips from Tbilisi, the capital here, I do think that Georgia is actually requires a lot more time than that because there's so much to see in this country and there's so many different regions. Each region of Georgia sort of has its own character. A lot of them are locked in the mountains, which means it can be hard to get there. Personally, I recommend trying to spend 2 weeks in Georgia or at least 10 days if you can. With that said, however much time you have in Georgia is better than nothing because as I said, it's my favorite country on the planet, so you should definitely visit. So with that, let's go ahead and dive into my recommended itinerary for how to spend 2 weeks in Georgia. All right, so on days 1 to 3, the first 3 days, you're gonna spend in the capital city of Tbilisi. National Geographic recently called it the world's most bohemian city, and as you wander the cobblestone streets of Tbilisi's old town, you'll understand why. There's this stunning fortress set up on the hill where you can get incredible views of the city. You can get up there by a cable car or you can hike up it. And you know, there's just so much to do in Tbilisi. There's lots of awesome cafes. There's an incredible nightlife scene. And you can take some day trips to other interesting historical sites around the city. I also highly recommend checking out the museums here or even taking in an opera if you're here on a weekend. All right, so for days 4 to 5, you're gonna head on up to the Kazbeki region, which is one of the most beautiful mountain parts of Georgia. On the way, you'll stop over at the Ananuri Castle, which is this like awesome castle set against a giant lake. It's really pretty. I think it's the most Instagrammable spot in all of Georgia. And then as you make it all the way up to Stepetsminda, I'm sure I'm saying that wrong, which is a town where you'll see this icon of Georgia, which is a church built on a hill. Nobody even knows how it was really built up there. You can hike up to that church, you can take a tour up there, and it's one of the most sort of iconic images of Georgia. So enjoy some time soaking in the mountains of Kazbek. All right, so on day 6, you're gonna have a travel day. You're gonna make your way down to the city of Kutaisi, and in the evening, you'll spend some time in Georgia's second city. If you have extra time to spend in Kutaisi, you can go check out some canyons, there's some caves, there's lots of natural things to do around Kutaisi. Kutaisi itself isn't the most interesting city in Georgia, in my opinion, so that's why we're only spending one night there. I would recommend checking out the restaurant scene there. There's this restaurant called Sisters that is really good. All right, so now's the part where it gets exciting, because on days 7 to 10, we're going to my favorite part of Georgia, which is the region of Spinetti. And so from Kutaisi, it's gonna take you a little bit of time to get up there. You'll have to take a marshuka or a minibus through these like winding roads. So if you get motion sick, be sure to be prepared for that. You'll arrive in the town of Mestia, which is the main hub in Spinetti. And from there, there's lots of amazing hiking that you can do all around this region. You'll find these ancient villages that have these like 1,000-year-old watchtowers that just really make for an incredible scene. The mountains there are super high. If you have time, I recommend going up to Ushgoli, which is the highest continuously occupied settlement in all of Europe and a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It's a small town, super high in the mountains, filled with these medieval watchtowers. And it's just such an excellent place to visit. It's my favorite place on my favorite country on the planet. So try to build some time into your itinerary to visit Ushgoli. All right, and now if you're the hiking or trekking person, you can spend the next few days doing some treks around Spinetti. But if you're not, on days 11 to 13, you're gonna make your way down to the seaside resort of Batumi. And Batumi's a weird place. It doesn't really fit in with the rest of Georgia, in my opinion. And while it isn't necessarily the number one place to visit in Georgia, I definitely think if you have 2 weeks, it's worth stopping by just to see it. It's kind of like if you took Singapore and Atlantic City and you mix them together and you plop them down in the middle of the Black Sea, you get Batumi. You have this like weird juxtaposition of this like super modern architecture. At one point they were gonna build a Trump Tower there, but that project got scuttled. But you'll see lots of these like really huge modern buildings. And then some of that is sort of, it's just such a contrast to the rest of Georgia, I guess is what I'm saying. And And also, of course, if you want some time at the beach, you know, they're pebble beaches, they're not sand beaches. But with that said, it can be a nice time to just sort of relax and chill out your last few days in Georgia. And then on your last day, you're going to make your way back to either Kutaisi or to Tbilisi. You can get a flight out of Kutaisi, that's closer to Batumi. And Wizz Air actually flies direct from Kutaisi to Europe, so you might be able to find some affordable flights. Otherwise, make your way back to Tbilisi and then take your flight home. You'll find that even with those 14 days, you'll feel like you've missed a lot of stuff in Georgia because there's just so much to do in this wonderful country. So for more information to help you plan your trip, be sure to check out my blog. I've got lots of information about Georgia to help you really explore this country that I love so much. So go ahead and check out those posts, sign up for my email list, and I'll send some of that information directly to you. And of course, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Enjoy your trip in Georgia.